She is a woman on top of the world. Rizalina Hervasho Mantaring is the Chief Executive Officer and President of Sun Life of Canada Philippines, one of the country's largest and most trusted insurance companies, and the Philippines' oldest, now 117 years old, having been established here in 1895. It's a combination of hard work, guts, and perfect timing that saw Mantaring's rise to the top. Under her leadership, the company has moved into this new address, the Sun Life Center, the country's first green building, which is LEED or Leadership in Energy and Environmental Design certified for design and construction. Built to save energy, use water more efficiently, and reduce carbon dioxide emissions. It is here that the woman CEO now holds office. Mantaring has been at the helm of Sun Life for 2.5 years now. Her climb to the top has been meteoric.
To those who aspire to be like you, how was it, you know, the climb? You'll be entering your 20th year, no?
Yes,
in Sun Life. So when you started, you were, how would we, which part of the ladder were you in?
I was already hired with experience. So I was hired as head of information technology for Asia. I think it's really just doing the best whatever you're given, and really understanding the business that you're in. So even if you're in information technology, it's important to understand the business that you're in for you to be able to deliver value.
So you don't just devote your attention to your department, your IT, and not expand, I suppose, your knowledge.
That's right. Because otherwise, even for IT, how do I determine what the company needs if I don't understand what the business is?
But you had no idea at all about insurance. I mean, that wasn't your forte when you joined Sun Life.
No, it wasn't my forte. When I joined, I didn't know much about life insurance, but I studied it. I studied the operations, and of course, like I say, always try to excel whatever you do and understand the culture of the organization, understand the people, and try to build relationships within the company, because it's very important to do that, because everything gets done through people.
You would not have thought that you'd be sitting, you know, where you are now.
Yes, that's right. When people would ask me, do you have that roadmap? Because people will always tell you, you have to plan your career. And I'm a very bad example because I never did. It was just whatever I was given, I tried my best, I did my best, and if I was given the next assignment, I do my best, whatever that assignment was. And it was really just do everything you're given.
And then I guess you shine and you're spotted.
You're spotted, yeah. You're given the opportunities, and whenever you're given an opportunity, make the most out of it, because you may never be given the same opportunity again.
And as CEO, she made sure she seized opportunities for her company. Early last year, Sun Life Financial Philippines acquired 49% of the Yuchenko-owned Grepa Life, forming Sun Life Grepa Financial. She also embarked on a 5-year strategy to use communication tools to increase financial literacy among Filipinos, which earned her the 2011 CEO Excel Award from the International Association of Business Communicators.
Family soon.
The company's pioneering It's Time campaign resulted in unprecedented growth for Sun Life locally, even gaining the attention of top company officials in Sun Life's headquarters in Toronto, Canada, who viewed the campaign in a recent conference in the United States. Mantaring was among only a handful of women and Asian executives in attendance.
Financial literacy is really something that's very dear to our hearts here in Sun Life. That's why we came out with a financial literacy campaign, because we found out that most people really are unprepared. They don't understand finances at all. The It's Time campaign has received numerous awards, and it's also one of the reasons why I did get that CEO Excel Award for communication. It's because really it's an effort to educate the Filipino. If you notice, it's really a financial advocacy. In the beginning, Sun Life wasn't even prominent in all the material that we had. It was really all about It's Time to protect your future.
And why did you think that necessary? Because of an advocacy, or in the end, well, it would benefit for the company if people are more aware.
Are more aware, that's right. Because we have products that we would like to sell. Obviously, we're trying to think of how do you penetrate the market more. And then we did market testing and realized financial literacy was quite low. So we said, how do you get a person to buy something that they don't see a need for? That's going to be very difficult, right? Especially for a financial product. Mm-hmm. They don't think they need it. They're not going to go and buy it. Mm-hmm. So he said, no matter what you do to push Sun Life or the product, if they don't realize, they don't see the need for it, it won't sell. So we said, okay, we do the financial literacy campaign, try to educate Filipinos a bit more. And in doing so, we realized we're going to be helping not just ourselves, but our competitors by educating the market. But that was fine. Mm-hmm. We said, grow the pie rather than fight over a small pie.
Tell us about the effect on the economy.
Life insurance is a great way of harnessing savings and helping capital markets development. The life insurance industry as of the end of 2010 had close to 500 billion in assets under management. And that 500 billion is invested in government bonds, which are used to finance infrastructure and all the government projects that we have. And in general, in running government, it's used to for corporate loans, to finance business. Mm. So it really helps the economy. So this is one way of harnessing the savings of the population to help in the development of the country in general.
For Mantaring, gender was never a barrier in her pursuit of a successful career. Mantaring is breaking the glass ceiling for many women aspiring for positions of leadership and authority.
But it's still a man's world, no? I mean, there have been many women who have risen to CEO positions, but it's still dominated by men. Mm-hmm. Would you agree?
I think so.
So, how is it like in, you know, mixing with your counterparts? I'm sure in the associations you belong to. How does it feel? In a room full of suits.
That's right. And I'm the shortest person in the room. That's interesting because I always get asked that. How does it feel to be the only woman in a room full of males? But I've never actually felt it because maybe it's part of it's being in the Philippines, mm-hmm. which is a society that's very accepting of women in executive positions, mm-hmm. I think, more than other societies are. So I've not really felt the difference in dealing with them. Mm-hmm. We deal with them really on a business level, just mm-hmm. like you would with any other person, and they would deal with me the same way.
So gender isn't an issue so much. You don't feel it. You don't feel like they look not down, but they feel more superior, perhaps? No.
No, I don't get that feeling. Well, it's an advantage when you're heading one of the largest companies. They can't look down on you. But I think it's also that people, I think, in general, these days are more gender neutral in the sense that they value or they judge you based on what they feel you deliver. Mm-hmm. And I've not felt that from others, that just because I was female, it made a difference to how they dealt with me. In fact, in some situations, it's probably an advantage because sometimes it's easier to be a female discussing things with them because then the egos don't get in the way.
So it can be an advantage.
And
you use it.
I wouldn't say that exactly. But maybe, yes, we're, I wouldn't exactly say take advantage.
I guess what's important is your capability.
Yes, what's really important is your capability.
Next, on People.
I was working 16-hour days again. And you have a baby at home. And then working 16-hour days, that was really tough for me.